Hi there, it's Sandy Alnock, and today I am going to do a page that's inspired by this man, Eric Carl, who just died recently, and you may remember him from being a children's illustrator. He wrote The Hungry Caterpillar and did these wonderful illustrations. I don't know his technique, but I have been doing a series on my other YouTube channel making cards that are inspired by children's illustrators. And since I was working on some cards that are going to post tomorrow, I thought it might be fun to do a Bible journaling page as well. So I'm going to do the cover and really focus on hungering for God in this particular page. I'm going to start by making some background papers on Tomo River paper. This is going to keep it really thin for the Bible journaling because I'm going to make it a tip-in, and it's going to have the basic layer from the tip-in as well as all the layers that are going to be collaged on top. So I wanted to keep everything really thin, and this paper is super, super thin, so it should work pretty well. For each one of the pages, and I just made a whole bunch of them in all different kinds of color combinations, usually just two colors though. I was trying for keeping every square inch of the whole thing, wherever I ended up cutting a little piece out of, that there would be an interesting texture there, which means I need two colors because I don't want the paper showing through. I want solid color. So I would mix them on the paper itself to let all the brush strokes show and all of that kind of yummy-licious paint. And you can use any kind of paints for this, any kind of acrylic paints. And I suppose you could actually do this with watercolor if you just wanted to cover watercolor pages with watercolor and then cut those out to make a collage. You could probably do that too, but you'll get brighter colors probably out of acrylics. And I didn't have a purple in all of the paints that I have. I have a whole big basket full of random paints that are all different brands. I didn't have any purple, so I decided I would try to see if I could make two purples, make one light purple and one darker purple. And that required me just using some different kinds of purples. So on one of them, I used a light blue and I used the same pink on both. And on this one, I used a dark blue, and I'll even add a darker blue still, and more of a navy blue to try to darken it a little bit more. It was a little harder to do a dark purple. Be careful when you're mixing purples, because if you use like a tomato red rather than a pinkish kind of, you know, pinkish purple type of red, you could end up with brown. That's what happened on one of my previous ones because I tried my other red color, one that you can see in the upper right, and that was too warm. And as we probably know, if you've been watching my channel long enough, yellow, red, and blue together make a brown. And when you're using a warm red, you've got a little bit of yellow in that red. So you don't have just red and blue. You have red, yellow, and blue. So you could get some weird neutrals. So I tossed that page because it came out looking terrible and I didn't think I'd use that color. But I proceeded through all the colors of the rainbow here for myself so I could have a good selection, because I was going to make a bunch of cards with these as well as making this Bible journaling page. So I'm just painting away. The surface that I'm using underneath of all this is freezer paper. So if you decide to do this with your kids and you want to keep things tidy, then put down some freezer paper on the table and you can just wipe that up and then they could reuse the freezer paper. These will take a while to dry. It depends on how thick you make the paint. You might have to leave them overnight in order to get them really, really dry. But what I found was I waited about a half a day and some of them kind of stuck together as I was cutting out some paper. So what I did was cut a bunch of rectangles that I thought would be about the right size for my caterpillar and stacked them up and then cut them all together so I could cut a bunch at once. And some of them stuck together just ever so slightly. If they're really wet, then they'll really stick together like gooey. I made a panel for the bottom that was going to be the ground on my picture. And then I was going to try to make some sort of a sun for the top of this. The first circle that I made felt too big, so I decided to make a smaller one just using a round object, but then cutting it by hand so it would be really loose. And I was going to use the full yellow page in the background, so that was the colors that I was trying to think of when I was picking all of these little pieces to make my collage. But I tried to stick with Eric's colors for the caterpillar itself because I thought he made some good choices. I would love to know what his process was. I'll have to probably look that up online to see if I can discover how he did that, if this is the way he did. However, he probably did it really large. So he wasn't cutting teeny, teeny, tiny pieces like I am doing with all these little itsy bitses. But I've got most of my pieces cut out, and it is time to start thinking about assembly. And I decided I would use glue stick for this. Knowing that glue sticks have just what they're made of is going to dry. As long as it's wet, it's going to stick. But eventually, all of that may dry and things may fall off. And I had to resign myself to the fact that if I wanted to do this, it might come apart someday. However, being in my Bible, it might actually stay put. I don't really know. I can't promise that, but if you have some other paper glue, then that would probably be a little better of a choice, just so that you can make sure that you have something that's going to stay permanently. But you could always just re-glue the pieces if they do come off, so it's not all that bad a deal. And I'm just going to glue each one of mine. I cut my pieces too big, so as I went, I was trimming and then putting glue on them and then gluing them together and just kind of making a general curve for my layout of the caterpillar, just like is on the cover of the book. I ended up not cutting enough by the time I layered them on top of each other because I was originally laying it out, putting them next to each other, and I realized what Eric had done was put them on top of each other. His also looked like they were made on something transparent because you could see through layers underneath. So it's also possible that he layered in a different way. I don't really know how he did it, but this is my attempt to make a reasonable facsimile of it. And of course, his shapes were a lot better than mine. I like the face on his better than mine. But I also decided to change the purple sun. I wanted the purple sun rather than the red sun because there wasn't enough purple on here for me. And then I took a marker to make the little hairs on the caterpillar. Now on his book cover, he's got feet and he cut out feet, but those would be so tiny, I don't think my fingers could take it. So I decided I would not have feet on mine. I would just put the caterpillar hairs on the top and bottom. And then I used a little bit of Posca pen to try to add some details to a few things and give it my own personal spin and add the text onto it. I just cut out some strips of paper and then a big circle of paper for the text that I wanted to put on here so I could have the same kind of colors and the same feel, but you could also just write the words on top of the paper itself. And of course, nothing bleeds through the back of the paper because it's acrylic, which is kind of the same thing that's in gesso. So when you think of using a gesso, if you do anything on top of acrylic work, then it shouldn't bleed through. These are the cards that I'll be making this week on my other YouTube channel, if you want to see that, made out of the rest of the painted papers that I created in this video. I will see you again next week. Have a wonderful, wonderful one yourself, and I'll see you again soon.